Does it still feel unusual to just be taking a walk like this?
Yes, it does. It does. Yes, it does. Actually, to be out here today and to be walking in the sunshine is an amazing experience. It's almost surreal.
In 1993, then 17-year-old James Huff was convicted of murder and sentenced to life without the possibility of parole. In 2012, the Supreme Court ruled such terms unconstitutional for juvenile offenders. Huff was resentenced and last summer, after 27 years in prison, released.
That was my goal.
On a recent walk along Philadelphia's Rail Park, he showed us a large mural he'd helped design and create while in prison, a work he never thought he'd see in the outside world.
When we began to work on projects like these, they changed our lives. You know, they showed us a different way. It brought me peace, it brought me satisfaction.
Art helped change Huff's life, and now it's brought him to a very different side of the justice system. In November, he was named Artist-in-Residence for the Philadelphia District Attorney's Office. DA Larry Krasner wasn't sure what to make of it when he originally heard the idea, which is believed to be the first of its kind.
At first, I was a little confused because it's a new notion.
Confused, like, what is that? What does it mean?
Like, what is that? I mean, I have heard of the arts, but this is also a prosecutor's office, so it seemed like an interesting notion. The more I thought about it, though, and the more I spoke to people about it, it seemed like a really good idea.
Krasner is no stranger to controversial ideas and approaches. A lifelong defense attorney and activist for criminal justice reform, he was elected in 2017 as the city's top prosecutor, vowing to change a system he sees as wasteful of human lives and public resources.
What I and we are all trying to do is get away from this very, very ineffective, entirely retributive system that does not make us safer, but gives us things like mass incarceration, does not fund our schools, but funds a whole lot of prisons. You know, we cannot solve all of our problems by locking people up, by putting them in cuffs. It does not work. We know this.
His actions to date, including seeking little or no prison time for some offenses, have garnered wide attention, praise, and plenty of opposition. But how does an artist-in-residence program fit in?
Every black male who was in the park last night is a suspect.
Krasner cites culture, movies, TV series, music, taking on serious issues of criminal justice and perhaps changing hearts and minds. And he sees the arts project as a new way to reach the public.
You said you wanted a lot of data.
Yes.
Has anybody shown you the data lab downstairs yet?
Not yet.
He's quick to insist there is no public funding involved. The money comes from an outside foundation. And he vetted James Huff, his crime, his experience in prison, and of course, his artwork.
This is not propaganda. There's not necessarily an obvious message, something that tells you what to do. But to me, there was a kind of a really deep talent that was behind this, and it was supported by 20 years of developing his artistic abilities.
James Huff began drawing and painting as a child, but it was in prison that he became a serious artist, part of turning his life around. Older inmates advised him, make this your university, not your casket.
I felt like whatever I could do artistically would only matter in the larger sense as a human being in a society, as if I became a better person.
In 2006, at the State Correctional Institution at Graterford, Pennsylvania, he joined a program run by Mural Arts Philadelphia, a group known for using public art to both beautify and address social issues in the city. Huff and other inmates created works on fabric that were later transferred to walls around Philadelphia, like the one by the Rail Park, which involved help from prominent artist Shepard Fairey. It's called The Stamp of Incarceration. Jane Golden is the founder of Mural Arts.
There's something about redemption. And I think that art has a transcendent power, and somehow it's lifted something for so many of our stakeholders. James will now become a contributing member of our society.
In his new position, Huff will speak directly to different groups: the formerly incarcerated, victims and their families, and prosecutors. From those conversations, he'll create portraits and short videos for the public. I asked what message he wants to get across.
There's a human side to prosecuting crime, you know, and that can't be forgotten, that, you know, these are not charges, these are people. And so we need to figure out, how do we rehabilitate the person, we punish the crime, but we don't necessarily destroy the human being.
Make it personal, because you can make it personal.
Absolutely.
Which is why you have this position, right?
Absolutely.
You don't deny that you committed a crime.
No, I don't. No, I don't.
And you don't deny that you deserve to go to prison.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Yeah. I've said this many times. At the time that my crime was committed, I was 17, and my punishment was appropriate and also effective, you know.
Effective in the sense of what?
In the sense that individuals who commit acts that destroy the public trust, that harm other individuals, there's a social price that must be paid for that. However, there's also a redemptive quality to human beings that we can never forget exists. And if we foreclose on that, we foreclose on our society.
James Huff's position will last 9 months. District Attorney Larry Krasner told us he's already being asked about the program by DAs in other cities and thinks the idea could spread. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Jeffrey Brown in Philadelphia.